in the examination paper, when you see this paper, normally there are 20 questions. And in this 20 questions, how the students will behave in the examination? They see the 20 questions. And what will happen is, some students will read all the 20 questions. First question he will read, he will think, okay, this I know. Second, something I can manage. Third, like this, he will plan for the 20 questions. That itself will take 15 to 20 minutes, wrong strategy. And if you have to see the whole question once, glimpse, this is called a glimpse of this question paper, normally which I do, it is a temptation for everybody, they want to see how the question paper is. You understand? But glimpse is necessary, but don't spend more time in the glimpse. Sometimes students will plan for all the 20 questions in the mind, then only start reading the first question. It is a negative factor because you will not remember what you have planned for the 17th question when you go to the 17th question after writing all this. Secondly, waste of time. So when a question paper has been presented to you, have a glimpse, fast. Sir, why the glimpse is needed? I am telling, don't waste so much time on the glimpse. Sir, then in that case, we should not have to glimpse. Directly go to the first question, we will write. Then we will see the second question, then we will write. No, this is also wrong. You have to have a glimpse of, let us say, 3 minutes at the maximum. Sir, why? Because when you see some terms in the examination in the 17th, 18th, 20th question, your mind will start to work. Unconsciously, it will work. When you are going to this question, you will generate more points, faster points. And the glimpse which you have seen now, all this will help you. But I am telling that this should be taking only 3 minutes just to see. Okay, the question is about globalization. This is about unification of Italy. Like this, that's it. Then you come to the first question, then you think about the first question. But your mind will be back, it will be working. Are you understanding? This is also very important. And next, sometimes in the examination, out of 20 questions, there are some questions which is called discuss, evaluate, critically evaluate, analyze. These terms used to appear. Some students have come and asked me, sir, do they really mean something? Definitely it means something. But you please understand, practically I am speaking, it means something. But whatever it means, you are not going to justify whatever it means in a span of, let us say, 6 minutes. In a span for a question of 5 marks or 10 marks or 12 marks. I am challenging many people, for the aspect of discuss or analyze an area, are we understanding? I am giving 6 to 7 minutes time for 12 marks question. That is the maximum time which is permitted. In the 6 minutes, let him write an answer for a discuss. Let him write an answer for analyze. Let me read the answer. Let us see what difference is there in this. I am telling that this discuss, analyze, all they are important. But when the time period is very less, when whatever you have to write which is very, very less, this significance of it decreases. So I am telling, don't give undue importance in trying to decipher the meaning for these terms like discuss, etc. Important, not as much as you have to think 2 minutes, 3 minutes to write about this. You understand? Sometimes people will say discuss means how you have to discuss about this itself. They will keep on thinking. 6 minutes, 7 minutes is the maximum time you are having for writing one question. See, these terms had relevance when we were writing mains. When we were writing mains, each and every question had around 33 minutes. 33 minutes was given 60 mark question. Then we can discuss, of course. We can analyze, critically analyze also we can do. You understand? 6 minutes you think. What critically? In speaking, of course, you can critically analyze in 6 minutes because you can speak so much in 6 minutes. You can speak, you can do this. In writing, practically it is not possible. Follow a strategy which is practically possible. Finished. Are we understanding? Next, important of all, please, I have already told this. Ensure that your handwriting is legible and understandable. And if you have to write it in a neat, clear, give some spacing. Everything you should have already practiced in the test, please follow the same thing. People ask whether we should use multiple colors. I am thinking you should use one color. If you want to use one more color also, either black or blue, for underlining you may use it. But don't give too much attention for this, because in 6-7 minutes nothing can be done. What is innovation in an answer is the way you present an answer is more important. There are two things which are very important in an answer. One, relevance to the question what you are writing. Whatever you are writing, whether it is relevant, that is very important. Number two, presentation. Whatever is relevant you are giving, how you are presenting that is very important. Some people may use examples to justify their stand. Some people may use tabulations. Some people may draw a rough sketch. All that is welcomeable. That is good. But time, please understand this time. And another important point which I have to tell is, please always have a note on the time. How, sir? Very simple. Some people will say they will keep an alarm like this. After 7 minutes, it will blink. Some sound will come. Suddenly, you will jump to the next question. This is not a note on time. You please understand. If you have written all this test, you will understand what I am speaking. In 3 hours, you have to answer 20 questions. Clear? After writing 10 questions, you see whether 1.5 hours is the time you have taken or slightly you exceeded 1.5 hours and more. It normally so happens that for the first 10 questions, you are going to consume 1 hour 45 minutes, and don't be panicked. Because when you approach the end of these answers, your handwriting will be fast, you will write very fast. Last 10 questions, that is the last 50% of the marks, can be written in 1 hour 15 minutes itself. Nothing to worry. But you are exceeding 2 hours for the first 10 questions, still 10 questions are there to be written, you are in trouble. So ensure that first 10 questions, it should be in 1.5 hours. 10 minutes more, nothing to worry. 15 minutes, danger zone. Then if it is crossing, you are in problem. Sir, then what to do, sir? Plan. Divide that 10 questions also, 1.5 hours also you plan. And in 45 minutes, see whether 5 questions are covered. Finished. Are you understanding? Don't spend too much time on any question. If you don't know, go to the next question. You may come back to this question later. Small, small points all will contribute. The difference between those people who have succeeded, those people who did not clear the mains, is very, very, very less. This I have seen. What a difference, sir. 30 marks difference maximum, I am telling. There are students who are maybe present here who have missed the mains examination, getting interview and then getting a service itself in 1 mark, 2 mark, 3 mark are existing. And sir, how this 1 mark, 2 mark can be increased? By following whatever I have said. If you judiciously do from now what level you are existing, 20 marks minimum it will be guaranteed. Half mark each question you can increase, and one question extra you can write by the time management. Unnecessarily by thinking about the past question papers, past means papers, you can just focus on that test which you are writing. 2-3 marks extra you can get in one paper. Each and every question, it is an opportunity for you to get mark. You please understand this. One question, definitely half mark, 1 mark you can easily get. Half mark you can get. When you are writing the answer, see that what best I can do so that I can get another half mark. See, whatever you are writing, that is your writing. But think that half mark, if I have to get extra, what I have to do? I will just underline 2, that's it. I'll small diagram I will draw. So every question, think that from the best you are walking, just another 10% more in the examination. Not wasting time, 10% more best you want to do. See, this 10% will get you half mark, 1 mark, etc. Are you understanding? Small, small things, if you really cater, definitely you are going to get around 30-40 marks more, and which is going to be the difference between the person who has succeeded and the person who has failed. This is a simple difference. So, before going to the mains itself, think whatever I have said in the mind, everything it has to go. It is like a meditation, you please understand. Of course, you are going to do writing work, but the mind controls you. Please understand this. The mind is very, very important. Just put everything in the mind before going to the examination itself. You sit for 15 minutes and think upon, this is what I am going to do. And this is what is called meditation. In this meditation, before going to the next test, I am telling before any examination, also this means I am telling you, before going to the next test, tomorrow, let us say tomorrow you are going to write the mains test, paper 1. Before the prior day in the evening, you sit for 15 minutes. Imagine yourself as if you are writing the examination. Now you get the question paper. Imagine that you got the question paper. Then how you will write? Then by this imagination in the mind itself, this is like a rehearsal. When you do this rehearsal in the examination, it becomes everything is fine. It is under control. The small exercises you do, this is going to get you 1 or 2 marks more because it gives you more confidence. You understand, no? So those people who are writing the mains, please follow all this so that definitely it is going to be an advantage for you, and you are going to clear this examination.